Good afternoon. First, we're going to take you straight to Melbourne and extraordinary pictures of a large chemical explosion that has left an entire factory engulfed in flames. As we go to where almost 200 firefighters are trying somehow to bring this blaze under control. Nine surrounding suburbs are under warnings as smoke continues to billow in the air and the adjoining highway has now been shut. A little earlier, our news helicopter captured the explosion after the site at Derrimut and barrels of chemicals flying through the air. And yet, remarkably, at this stage, we are not hearing about any injuries. But as we mentioned, it has been playing out alongside a major highway. Stand by for a live update from our reporter who was at the scene very shortly. Well, Anzac Day commemorations in New South Wales will become even more focused next year, with the Minns government extending retail trade bans on the day. The details from Mark Burrows.
Well, this is the Hyde Park Memorial in the centre of Sydney. Each year, this building and the cenotaph in Martin Place is the focus for Anzac Day commemorations. But Premier Chris Minns is now concerned that because the big retailers can reopen at 1 p.m, the solemnity and the importance of the day is being jeopardised. So, from next year, all the big retailers will have to remain shut for the entire day. The move has the support of the RSL, other veterans organisations, and even the union representing shop workers. They believe the Premier has made the right call.
For the first time in a long time, acknowledge that it is a special day that should be set aside for commemoration. There'll be some disruption and a bit of inconvenience, but frankly, it's a small price to pay.
I think it's a great way to ensure we protect the sanctity of Anzac Day, our most important Veterans Day in the calendar year. It will allow our members, our veterans and their families to attend commemorations in Sydney and be with their families during those times.
And those wishing to indulge in the Anzac Day ritual of a two-up game need not worry. Pubs will still be open, also chemists and cafes. And the Premier says that in the spirit of coming together, the footy, the NRL, will still be on.
An Australian First agreement has been signed to speed up the rollout of renewables as a new report warns of massive wage losses in the coal and gas industries. For more, let's go to our Canberra Federal Politics reporter, Claudia Vajoljak. Claudia, good afternoon. What's the plan?
Well, Davina, this new agreement locked in between the Commonwealth and South Australia is designed to remove the barriers to get more renewable projects off the ground. The federal government will underwrite developers, giving them security to build wind and solar infrastructure, enough to power all households across Adelaide. Energy Minister Chris Bowen making the announcement at an old coal-fired power station in Port Augusta this afternoon, turbocharging the race to renewables at the very site the Coalition wants to create nuclear energy, a policy in stark contrast that will be entirely funded by the taxpayer rather than relying on the private sector. And as demand for green energy grows, the latest OECD economic outlook warns some jobs in the coal and gas industry are disappearing, and workers in high emission sectors can expect to see their salaries slashed by 29% over 6 years. It's not just those industries feeling the pinch, though, all workers are. That same report revealing Australia has one of the worst real wage growth of the 38 OECD countries, almost 5% lower at the end of 2019 and far behind the US and UK. The opposition and business bodies both blaming the federal government for not reining in inflation.
It's an indictment on this government's failure to beat homegrown inflation. The Reserve Bank is left with an invidious task of trying to get it back under control when the government is making the situation worse by throwing fuel on the inflationary fire.
We're at a tipping point for business. You know, we are walking the tightrope at the moment, and there's really no room for error. We need to have productivity underpinning the wages growth that we're seeing. Otherwise, it won't be sustainable.
We inherited a position where real wages were going backwards at an alarming rate, but they are now advancing again, and that's because of our strong efforts to get wages moving.
And there has been growth in real incomes this year for the first time in nearly 3 years. But the report also makes it clear households are still struggling in Davina. While the Treasurer has acknowledged that pain, Jim Chalmers says the government's measures are making a difference.
OK, Claudia, thank you. Another arrest has been made in Mexico in connection to the alleged murders of Perth brothers Jake and Callan Robinson, killed while on a surfing trip in May. 31-year-old Ahil Jesus taken into custody. There was a warrant out for his arrest for aggravated homicide. Hollywood actor Alec Baldwin's criminal trial is now underway in the US state of New Mexico over the 2021 on-set shooting death of cinematographer Helena Hutchins. Our US correspondent Lauren Tomasi reports from Santa Fe.
A jury has now been selected and sworn in. Everyday men and women who will be the ones to decide if Hollywood actor Alec Baldwin is criminally responsible for the shooting death of Helena Hutchins on the film set of Rust. Alec Baldwin arrived to the Santa Fe court with his wife Hilaria, their baby, the pram and the nanny, a family affair as the criminal case got underway. 70 prospective jurors were asked if they could be unbiased in their judgment. Two said no, two more said they'd never even heard of the case. Alec Baldwin is accused of involuntary manslaughter over the 2021 death of cinematographer Helena Hutchins, who was killed by the gun Baldwin was holding during rehearsals on the Western set of Rust. Baldwin is insistent he did not pull the trigger.
An actor should be able to rely upon professionals and shouldn't have to check everything in such great detail, except this was a real gun, and guns are deadly. This would have taken a matter of seconds to show him that it was unloaded, but instead he took somebody's word for it.
It's been a long and winding road to get here to this trial. Months after being charged in 2023, Alec Baldwin's case was sensationally dropped. But then, in January of this year, the actor was indicted again by a grand jury. And after multiple attempts to have the case dismissed, he was ultimately ordered to stand trial. Prosecutors intend to highlight what they say is Baldwin's neglect on set when it comes to safety. But in one win for Baldwin, his role as a producer on the film has been ruled irrelevant to this case. The Rust armourer, Hannah Gutierrez-Reed, has already been found guilty in a separate trial. She was sentenced to 18 months in prison, which is the same jail time which Alec Baldwin could see if he too is found guilty in this case.
An impressive changing of the guard in Canberra today, with three RAAF stealth warplanes roaring overhead to mark a new era at the top of the Defence Force. General Angus Campbell officially handing the reins over to new Defence Force Chief Admiral David Johnston at a special change of command parade.
I will serve as your chief by our values and watchwords of service, courage, respect, integrity and excellence.
General Angus Campbell has led the ADF for 6 years during a time of regional and global security challenges.